Hi viewer, welcome to Edim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through geography from 3, lesson 1. The topic it is statistical methods. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mudhoni. Welcome. We are going to look at the lesson goals. That is, we start by looking at the cumulative bar graph, what it is cumulative bar graph, and how we can be able to construct the cumulative bar graph. We start by looking at cumulative bar graph. Cumulative bar graph, it is also referred to as the compound bar graph. It comprises of one bar or more bars drawn vertically or horizontally, with each bar subdivided so that each portion represents a whole component of the data that makes the whole. This is whereby now you get one bar as more subdivision, or it is subdivided in order for us now to make if it is data for the whole year, different commodities can be represented in that bar. So that is the reason as to why you refer to it as the cumulative bar graph. Or even a commodity, the way it has been produced within a month, we can put it in one bar in order for us now to get the total cumulatively. Where 2 or 3 bars are drawn, each bar is separated with an equal space between them. So you get the bars are not joined together. You must separate the bars with a space. And the space must be equal between the bars. Suitable for representing data depicting the total value of 7 items. So it is very suitable method to represent the data in case now we are representing data that is giving us the total value of 7 items. How do we construct the cumulative bar graph? Steps that are followed. First step, we find the totals of each year, finding the cumulative totals for the data. So that is the first thing. We must get the cumulative totals. That is the CF. Step number 2, after getting the cumulative totals, you draw the X and Y axis and decide on the width of the bars and the space between them. So that is step number 2. Draw the X and Y axis, then get the scale. After that, getting the scale for the X axis, we get the scale for the Y axis. How do we get the scale for the Y axis? This is by considering the largest and the smallest values in set of statistics being represented. Number 4, then from there, you draw the outline of each bar with its components and shade each component differently. So after getting the scale, so the next thing, it is now drawing the outline of each bar. Remember, the outline is given by the cumulative data that you have calculated. Then from there, the subdivision is done by the total of each component. The part of each bar representing the same component should be the same. The way we represent, the way we shape, this information should be similar from one bar to another for the comparison purpose. So if at all you have decided this commodity, I'm shading it blue, so it means that the next one will be blue. The next bar, in the next bar, it should be blue. So you get a specific color. Then the next one, we derive a comprehensive key to indicate what each shading represent on the graph. After that, we just label the axes to show that the x and y axes represent. So we label them. And then finally, we put a short and clear title in space above the graph, stating what the graph is representing. This is the kind or summary of what you're supposed to get. You have the title, we have the key, we have the bars there. Then that marks the end of our lesson. We are going to do an example in our next lesson. So the assignment, the activity for today, highlight the procedure for when constructing the cumulative bar graph. The reference, it is KRB, student book 3. That is where you can get more information. For more information, you can get us through the SMS. You can get us through the YouTube. You can also get us through the Facebook or even through the Twitter. Stay tuned to LMTV. Thank you.